Hello, my name is Sam and welcome to West Northamptonshire. In this video, we'll be looking at the works taking place across a roughly 8 mile section of the HS2 route that stretches from here in Greatworth through to Chipping Warden, sharing details about some of the key structures we're delivering here, which will carry high-speed trains safely through the region in a mixture of tunnels, viaducts, bridges, cuttings and embankments. This is a crucial section of the route, situated almost halfway between the railway's two infrastructure maintenance depots at Calvert in Buckinghamshire and Washwood Heath in East Birmingham, and a section that will be a key test area during the railway's trial operations phase in the future. We'll be taking a detailed look at what we're building here and share some of the challenges that our teams have faced to date and how we're overcoming them. We'll be focusing on the two longest green tunnels on the route, Greatworth Green Tunnel and Chipping Warden Green Tunnel, three major viaducts that we're delivering in this section, Lower Thorpe, Edgcote and High Furlong Brook, and an in-depth look at our earthworks activity that when complete will link the structures together seamlessly to provide a smooth, efficient and reliable journey for passengers. We start our tour here at the entrance to Greatworth Green Tunnel. This is one of the five main green cut and cover tunnels that we're building on HS2. When complete, this will be the longest green tunnel on the route at around 1.6 miles or 2.7 kilometers long. It will be buried below ground and hidden from view, enabling HS2 trains to pass beneath the West Northants countryside with no disruption to the local community. We construct these tunnels by first excavating the earth, pouring the concrete base and building up the tunnel structure on top, and then backfilling it with earth to bury it. This tunnel, like its sister tunnels at Chipping Warden and Wendover, is built using precast concrete segments which are delivered to site, lifted into place and slotted together to create the double arch that you can see behind me. This tunnel is being built in two sections, the northern section and the southern section. To date, we've installed almost 1,000 metres of the tunnel arches, and as you can see, we're already in the process of backfilling earth on top of the structure. This is an important moment in the construction of this tunnel because it will allow us to realign the B4525 Welsh Road over the top of the tunnel and continue to excavate the southern section of the tunnel. As we head north, the next major structure that we arrive at is Lower Thorpe Viaduct. Set into a valley, the 220 metre viaduct will carry high-speed trains across Banbury Lane and help manage flood risk by ensuring that rainwater can continue to run off into existing watercourses. Lower Thorpe Viaduct is a double composite steel and concrete structure. In June, we launched the steel and the concrete deck of the viaduct into position in just 3 days. It is one of 15 major viaducts that our construction partners EKFB are delivering for HS2 between the Chilterns and South Warwickshire. It is also the last of the five viaducts being built using this technique. With the steelwork in position, our teams have already begun the next stage of the operation. The lowering of the deck onto the permanent bearings has been completed, and the team have now started on the in-situ concrete deck works ahead of parapet installation. The 515 metre long Edgcote Viaduct will carry the railway across the floodplain of the River Cherwell, south of Chipping Warden. This structure is made up of 40 precast 70 tonne piers with two 100 tonne precast beams spanning each pair of piers. Each of the precast elements are delivered to site and installed using a combination of cranes and tandem lifts. All 40 piers are installed and we're very close to completing the installation of all of the precast concrete deck beams. This streamlined approach to off-site manufacture and precast modular installation not only accelerates construction, but also reduces the carbon footprint of the structure.
The Edgcote itself is a really interesting site. It's one of our most environmentally sensitive, not only with the River Cherwell, but also some historic ridge and furrow in the environment. So we've had to design all the temporary works around here that didn't require us to remove topsoil. And we've also got to, once we've finished the structure, return it back to its original state without affecting the old historic ridge and furrow work. We've also got some really sensitive environmental receptors with some triple SIs around us. So the team have worked really hard with the EA and other stakeholders to make sure that we're complying with our environmental best practice and ensuring we're doing the best we can for the environment whilst building the asset required.
Continuing north, our trains will pass through the second green tunnel on this section, the 1.5 mile or 2.5 kilometre long Chipping Warden Green Tunnel. Like Greatworth, we are constructing this tunnel in two sections, each separated by a road. Construction started in 2022, and whilst our team have faced many challenges, this is now the most advanced green tunnel on this section, and lessons learned during its delivery are helping to accelerate productivity on our green tunnels at Greatworth and Wendover in Buckinghamshire. Construction of the northern section is now largely complete, with over 1 mile of concrete, foundations and blinding in place, over 1,500 metres of precast concrete arches installed, and over 1,100 metres of the site has been handed to our earthworks team for backfill. Our team is building the northern porous portal, which will reduce the noise of the trains entering and exiting the tunnel, along with the small portal buildings to house safety and electrical equipment. At the southern end, the concrete foundations are almost complete and more than half of the precast concrete arches are installed.
We're here at Chipping Warden North at the North Porous Portal, where we're carrying on with the install of the porous portal itself, which started just about a month ago, and it's progressing nice and steady at the moment. The weather's been fantastic so far this year, and we've really made the most of it, in particular Earthworks and the tunnel team. So we've handed over 1,000 metres, we've handed over Section 6, which is where the A361's being diverted. Earthworks have worked really, really hard to actually get it to a phase where they can now hand it over to the highways team, and they're starting to work on it. So the key for us is getting the road diverted, creating that connectivity back to the local neighbourhoods, and also gives us the opportunity then to take up the plug and finally join up this piece of tunnel behind us, which would be a massive milestone for us. We've got the porous portal, as you said there, we started that, we'll finish that off this year. We then have the porous portal coming up in about 2 months over at Chipping South, so we'll take a lot of lessons learned from this one, take it over to Chipping South, so that's a big piece over there to complete. In terms of other works coming up at the moment, a lot of handed over to Earthworks, and like I said, the key at the moment is making sure we're ready for the future works that aren't directly coming now, but next year time robust curves needs to be as efficient as possible. We've taken many learnings from this tunnel to pass on to the other tunnels, in particular Greatworth South, which is the one that's going to be starting at the back end of this year. So the key ones are, you know, in terms of the reinforcement for the inverse slab, prefab cages is key to make things go faster and make things safer. The installation of the units, the team will be trained up, and most likely take teams that are finishing up here and put them over to Greatworth South so they understand the precast unit installation. The waterproofing, we understand that it should be prefabbed off-site, comes into site as fabricated as possible, so reduce the work on site. And then the way we access to do the works, we try to keep everything separate. So we've learned from here, we need to keep things as separate as possible. So over at Greatworth South, we're gonna have our invert gantries completed, they'll be built, and they're gonna go straight into the tunnel. So it's off the mark, right way, first time, that's the key. At Greatworth though, because we haven't started the south section, we're gonna get the invert gantries early, so go straight in, keep all the tasks separated. So for instance, again, another learn will be the blinding slab. So the blinding slab initially was all in situ steel again, it took probably 14 to 15 steel fixes to complete it in a day or two. Now we change it to a rollout carpet. The rollout carpet reinforcement, again, prefabbed off site. We bring it in, we use the excavator to put it on the ground. The fixes just roll it out. You just need 4 or 5 fixes to do it in one day.
As we exit the Chipping Warden Green Tunnel, our trains will travel across the 163 metre long High Furlong Brook Viaduct near the village of Aston-le-Walls in Northamptonshire. It crosses High Furlong Brook, a tributary of the River Cherwell that joins the Thames at Oxford. Consisting of 7 spans, the viaduct crosses the brook at a height of around 9 metres. The viaduct was structurally completed just over a year ago in September 2024, the first viaduct to reach the stage on the entire HS2 programme. Since then, our earthworks teams have been working hard to build up the embankments that support the railway to either end. As we stand next to the viaduct, it provides a glimpse into the future of the journey that our trains will take as they exit the green tunnel and head across the embankment and onto the viaduct. Connecting each of our major structures together are our cuttings and embankments, which are being delivered through our extensive earthworks programme. This is the process of excavating material to create the space below ground level where the railway will run in cuttings, and building up the embankments that will carry the line above grounds and enable trains to travel seamlessly across viaducts and bridges. In this section of the route, earthworks have also played a crucial role in the delivery of our green tunnels, with the material excavated in order to prepare the foundations of the tunnel. We have a fleet of some 400 construction vehicles which operate every day on this section of the route, lifting material, transporting it, and then placing it, either to build up the embankments that our trains will run on or to store it for future backfilling of the green tunnels. So far this year, our production rates for earthworks have been really impressive, the result of careful planning, interdisciplined teamwork, and closely working with our supply chain to manage, maintain, and move our fleet. Last month alone, over 1.7 million cubic meters of material was moved, a record on the HS2 programme and another indication of the scale of the work that we're delivering.
Earthworks across G2S is one of our most significant activities. We've had huge progress this year. Whilst helped by the weather, we've also had an increased improvement in productivity and a focus on data. The data has allowed us to really focus in on our challenges and allow us to focus on solving the problems before they become big issues. And this has seen a huge productivity increase across our programme. It's also allowed us to capitalise where we're making more advantage. Greatworth Green Tunnel is a good example where we've increased our excavation, which is allowing us to make more programme certainty. The relationship between earthworks and tunnels couldn't be stronger. You can't build the tunnel without completing the excavation. And you can't complete the excavation if you've got nowhere to put the muck. You can't put the muck anywhere until you've completed the tunnel and allowed us to backfill it. The relationship is intrinsic. We now have over 180 ADTs on site, and we've worked really hard to remove the blockers and increase our productivity. Not only that, we've also had a huge focus on safety. If you look at our automated barriers that we've implemented this year, we've got a system that allows the ADTs to drive faster because they've got the confidence that our crossing points will correctly stop the plant and avoid any collisions. This has allowed us to go 2 kilometres faster, and it's also prevented any incidents between our plant and our workforce. A real bonus both to safety and productivity. Teamwork in G2S has been really strong. I joined the project in September last year, and since then I've really seen the team grow together to rise with the challenges. This year is all about working together. We're no longer individual assets, and the completion of a structure leads on to completion of the earthworks, and the two are so closely linked. Without completing the structures, we can't do the backfill and achieve the quantities we need this year to lead into a successful year next year. This year has really been about starting to see the structures come out of the ground and really form the skeleton of what GTS will become. I've seen embankments rise out of nothing, as you can see at High Furlong Brook, and you can really see some of our major cuttings starting to take shape. Lower Thorpe North, with the piling completed, we're now working really hard to coordinate moving the site access road and the haul road to allow us to complete the excavations. And the teams are working really, really well together.
Thank you for watching. We hope you've enjoyed this updates video and it has given you a better understanding of the scale of the works taking place day in, day out to deliver some of the most complex and challenging engineering that has ever been undertaken in the UK. Let us know what you think in the comments. For more information about this section and other parts of HS2, subscribe to our YouTube channel, follow our social media channels, and visit our website at hs2.org.uk.